Good morning. Please join me in singing our processional song, following the breaking bread, number 721. Alleluia, sing to Jesus.
Oh, Almighty God, that we, who believe that your only begotten Son, our Redeemer, ascended this day to the heavens, may in spirit dwell already in heavenly realms, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught, until the day he was taken up. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, It is not for you to know the times or reasons that the Father has established by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he has lifted up, and cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky, as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm is found in the Wicked Red, number 767. God mounts his throne.
Oh,
May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of Him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to His call. What are the riches of glory in His inheritance among the holy ones? And what is the surpassing grandness of His power for us who believe? In accord with the exercise of His great might, which He worked in Christ, raising Him from the dead, and seating Him at His right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in His age, but also in the one to come. And He put all things beneath His feet, and give Him as head over all things to the church, which is His body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Many of you might remember that many years ago, one of the things for churches or institutions of any kind was that it was very popular to develop a mission statement. And if you've ever been through one of those processes of developing a mission statement, you know how tedious it is. It's not always easy, and sometimes they wind up being not really much of anything other than we agree on what we have, but it's kind of vague here or vague there. And, you know, they didn't, to my mind anyway, they didn't always capture, you know, the essence of the place. And not too long ago, there was a book being published about reinvigorating Catholic parishes, you know, with new vision statements. And at one of the conferences, a young priest stood up and went like this. He said, the convener said, "Yes, Father, what is it?" He said, "Jesus did not give a mission statement. So I don't know why we're developing these." Yes, he did. And you just heard me proclaim it in the gospel. Very simple mission. "Go, therefore, teach all nations, and baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Why? Because at the ascension, with the ascension, what happens to us is that we become that sacramental church that Jesus, by his nature, takes with him and gives to us still. So his promise to remain with us to the end of the age is so evident, especially in our sacramental life. Now, granted, we've been apart from that for a while. We're getting ready, however, slowly, with great deliberateness, to be able to say, "Come back home," a little bit at a time. And doing that little bit at a time, we come to appreciate more, I believe, the gift of the Eucharist. So on this Feast of the Ascension, rejoice and be glad. We temper this, of course, with knowing that there are still people out there suffering, people who need our prayers, people are working very hard. But the Ascension of the Lord gives us this whole notion of understanding who we are as church. "I am with you always, even to the end of the age," says the Lord. Jesus said it. I believe it. Let us trust in what God has done.
Let us pray.
For the promises of Jesus to give us hope and peace, knowing he is with us always until the end of time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all priests to be empowered by the risen and ascended Lord, and with the courage of the apostles, proclaim to the world their need for Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world to emerge from the tomb of the pandemic, to rise to a new life of solidarity among all people and respect for all creation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people to be humbled by these unprecedented times and be aware that all life is in the hands of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our ancestors in faith, for the Jewish people, for the prophets and apostles, for priests, and for all the faithful, for continued endurance in anticipation of the day Christ will come again, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all victims of this pandemic, for those who are sick, weary, and afraid, and for Lisa Carew and Marie Caboni, for the healing and peace that only Christ can give, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For family and friends who have gone before us, and for all who have no one to remember them, that they know the joy of eternal communion with our ascended Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all servicemen and women and their loved ones, for the intentions in our parish book of prayers and on our prayer line, and for all those prayers deep within our heart that are known to God alone, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty and ever-loving God, hear the prayers that come from our hearts this day. Strengthen us in the joy of our faith to do your will. In the name of Jesus Christ, your Son,
lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Our offertory song is found in the Breaking Bread, number 506, Now We Believe.
Thank you.
gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, the supper was ended, the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Peace.
behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof, but you say the word, my soul shall be healed.
The new song is from the Breaking Bread number 620, Make Your Home in Me.
Thanks be to God.
Our final song is from the Breaking Bread, number 170.